You build your name in the industry, and you are ready to make the leap and advance to L8. Well done. Great decision. You go to the L8 online store. The link will be in the description. Going through the website, checking the different versions and options to know which is the best for you. But you don't exactly understand what each version include and what each function does. For example, moving object or DMX recorder. Don't feel bad. It happened to all of us. The system is so advanced and loaded with the latest technology. I also often find myself thanking to the support team and asking what the function does and how it works and how to use it. To save your time, I will do an in-depth review of the different L8 versions and all the feature packs, so-called FPs. Show and explain the listed features one by one so you know exactly what each feature does and what you're paying for. L8 is the next generation visualizer software designed to bring your idea to life and present your vision to the clients. Well, first, L8 come in two separate configurations: the CE version, which unlocked by internet serial code, and Pro version, which comes with the physical dongle. CE, perfect for beginners and small businesses, offers essential tools to create impressive visualizations and crazy performance with ease. The Pro versions, for powerful users and large teams, provide advanced features that meet all your professional needs. Buy the CE version through the L8 online store and immediately receive a serial code to activate the software without the need for a physical dongle. This code is specific to one computer only. Once you have entered it, it will not work on any other computer. You will also not be able to upgrade the hardware on the existing computer. The only hardware component that can be upgraded is the video card. Any other upgrade will cause the serial code to stop working. CE divide into four subversions, CE1 to CE4, with CE1 being the basics, while CE4 being more serious and the most advanced of the CE family. All CE versions receive regular updates and technical support for 1 year from the moment you purchase. After this 1 year passed, the software will still work as always, but you will no longer get updates and no technical support. To receive updates again, you need to buy the software again and replace the old serial code with the new code you will receive. Just click on the serial number at the bottom of the welcome screen and you can enter the new code. CE license can be upgraded to a higher license. For example, if you have the CE1 and you want to upgrade to CE2, you can. CE2 to CE3 to CE4. It is very important to know that there is no connection between upgrading the software version and the time you have left for updates and support. For example, you bought your CE1 and after 6 months you want to upgrade the software to CE2 because you want more features. So you will only have another 6 months of update and support for this CE2 license, which means that after these 6 months have passed, the red update button will stop flashing, and to receive updates and support, you will have to buy CE2 again. Remember that even after this 1 year is passed, you can always go to the L8 website and download the latest version of the software. This does not include library updates or technical support, mainly bug fixes and optimization. Let's move on to the Pro versions. There are three: Media, Trace, and the big one, Unlimited. You also buy them through the L8 online store, only here, unlike the CE, you do not receive a serial code. A physical USB dongle will be mailed to you that opens the software when connected to computer. Delivery time usually take up to 14 days. It is impossible to open one of the Pro versions without connecting the dongle to the computer. There is no problem running the software from another system or upgrading the existing system. Just connect the USB dongle to another computer and the software will open. Updates and technical support are for life with no time limits, and you can upgrade the software without paying full price for a more advanced version. For example, if you already have Media, you can upgrade to Trace for only 1,000 euros, instead of paying the full Trace price, which is 2,800 euros. You can also add one of the feature packs to your license even after you buy it. This way, you will get exactly the feature you need and save a lot of money. Bring us to our next section, which is the feature packs, so-called FPs. In addition to its core versions, L8 offers feature packs. These packages allow you to expand the software capabilities with special tools and add-ons tailored to your specific requirements, ensuring that you only pay for what you need. You get all these packages with every new purchase of one of the pro versions. Buy a media or trace or unlimited license today and you'll get all the feature packs FP19 to FP24. Adding FPs to an existing pro license is also possible, and this saves a lot of money without having to buy a new license. For example, if you have a media license and you want the HDRI feature, just buy the FP22 package, which includes this feature. Just a side note, it is not possible to add this package to the CE versions. These come with a fixed number of features and that's it. Great, you have the basics. Now we will go through each option in the list and understand what it does. Let's start with the first one, ArtNet, SACN, and VC Universes. This means how many universes the software gets into it. HOC 4 Universes. How many universes in the HOC 4 protocol the software can accept. MANET Universe. How many universes in the MA protocol the software can accept. Note that unlike HOG, the MA need MA hardware to send parameters. Laser input, the number of inputs that allow different control of lasers. Video texture playback, the amount of video file that can be played simultaneously. Video texture input, the amount of video inputs that can enter into the software, an internal file, NDI input, or a capture card, etc. Resolume, for example, can send several different screens with different information, or even several programs at the same time. DMX camera patch, the option to control the software camera by DMX. Move and rotate it, this way you can program the movement of the camera as an integral part of your timecode show for a cinematic and accurate look. I made a video about it, you can check it out in my channel, I will also link it in the description. DMX profile constructor, build and edit custom feature types directly from the software. If you need a device that does not exist in the library, simply build it from scratch or edit an existing device and save it as an additional device in the library. Moving objects, camera path. It is possible to control the movement of objects in the software space by external control. It will be called dynamic layers. Move, rotate, increase or decrease the scale of any object in the software, all through DMX, so that you can insert those changes on your timecode as well. In addition, you can also associate the camera with a certain way that will make it look even more extreme. Moving objects collision allow. There will be time when you use kinetic engines or motorized robots for your show. The software allow a collision warnings in case you want to know exactly what will be the object movement limits in real time. Here is an example of kinetic engine that descend too much till it hit one of the stage elements. Virtual camera overall resolution. It is possible to place virtual camera that simulate a closed circuit and broadcast to the screen, CCTV and render them as part of the visualization. Annual update and support. We already went over this at the beginning of the video. The CE versions received update and support for 1 year and in the Pro version it is for life. There are many more options including the software that you can read about on the page of each version. Today I'm only talking about the features that are listed in the main list. If there is any feature you would like me to explain to you, write me in the comments and I will answer you. Let's move on to the feature packs called FPs. FP19, NDI texture input, the amount of NDI feeds that the software can receive. Animated character library, a complete library of dynamic objects such as people, animals, musicians, and dancers with different movement and state that can control their speed and movement. Of course, you can also add objects you created yourself. Symbol library, huge libraries of industry-specific objects such as trusses, speakers, barriers, etc. divided by the most well-known companies in our field. DMX recorder. Imagine that you need to present your idea to a customer. Instead of carrying the lighting console with you, you can record the DMX values you sent to the software on the memories and transmit them after that without having to connect the lighting console again. For example, I create a motion effect with my HOG and record it in the software. Now I disconnected the hog from the computer and activate the memory I recorded. Paperworks, the ability to make technical riders directly from the software. 2D mode with legends and quantities, color coded for object and lights, patch and names, and many more. I made a video on that also, you should really watch it, link in the description also. Fixtures per project, the amount of devices you can put into one project. With the media license, for example, in one project you can insert 512 Parkans or 512 Mac Viper. This number does not refer to the number of parameters in the device, it's referred to a net numbers of devices. FP20, MVR file import, the ability to import MVR files into the software. For those who don't know about MVR, Google it, there is a lot of information about it. Particles library, allow you to use the particle system of the software, a complete library of special effects such as fire, CO2, fireworks and more. They too can be controlled by DMX. Scaffold library, a complete library of scaffolding including all size and parts available and with an option to snap between the different parts. Camera focus, allow the software camera to focus on a certain object while its entire environment is in blurry situation, what's called in the photographer's language DOF, depth of field. Light emission, direct illumination, object with lighting will illuminate their surroundings. Fixtures per project, this refers to the trace license and increases the number of devices in it from 800 to 1000. By the way, Trace have another upgrade called Trace 2 that increases the number of devices to 2000. FP21, light reflection, indirect illumination, a unique ability for L8 reflection, light reflections and illumination through reflective surfaces in real time, such as mirror, mirror balls, chrome surface, etc. I made a video about this one not long ago, you can find it in the video description. Virtual reality Oculus, the ability to walk in a virtual space of the software with the Oculus 3D glasses in 360 degrees. Grandometry VSKI, allow MA VSKI to be used, you can read about it in the MA website. Crowd of characters, take one of the objects and quickly duplicate it into a shape of a crowd. Fixtures thumbnail browser, visual display of all devices in the list. L8's device libraries update on a daily basis. There are many devices and they are all registered and divided by companies. What better than seeing each device and understanding what it is to know if it fits your needs or not. Fixture per project, another license specific upgrade, this time to unlimited, which increases the number of the devices from 2000 to 4000. Alright, we get to FP22. HDR output, high dynamic range monitor can be used with L8. Display L8 screen in a notch image, for those who have an HDR screen, don't miss out this option, it's look just wow. HDR screen and video shots, allow you to record or take picture of the software screen in HDR format and share it with customers or upload it to YouTube which support HDR quality. Virtual production crane, connecting a tracking camera into the software for professional work in front of a green screen and production that required advanced and professional tracking camera work. Render to NDI, the ability to broadcast the software screen out to the network over the NDI protocol and capture it into external software such as OBS or Resolum. It's perfect for streamer or virtual productions. Panoramic screen video shots. You can export the entire virtual world you created in the software to a video or an image file and send it to a client or share it on YouTube, so that your audience can watch the entire virtual world you created in 360 degrees and even use 3D glasses and in HDR Plus format. Fixtures top 100 rating review. You can check the statistics of the top 100 devices in which all L8 users around the world use them the most. In addition, you can see statistics specific to your country and your region. In this way, you can understand which devices are realistically suitable for your production. The statistics are updates every week. HDRI environments. Open the possibility to create an HDRI environment at the click of a button for super realistic simulations and visuals. I also made a video about this and it will also be in the video description. FP23, multi-GPU outputs. You can create from one software a workstation for up to 4 operators working on the same project at the same time. Each of you will be able to sit in front of a monitor and be able to change the view without changing anything for your friends, all through only one software license without the need to buy 4 licenses. Multi-GPU single output acceleration. If the project is heavy and you want more performance, just add another graphic card to the system for maximum performance. On an RTX 380, you get 30 FPS, adding another RTX 3080 should give you 16 FPS. Of course, a lot of variables depend on it, but that's the concept. Multi-GPU video shots. Create and render the video on multiple video cards, faster and more rendering performance. 4 cameras quad view. Divide the screen into 4 different cameras that see the project in real time and separate control of each of them through the software or through DMX. 4 camera DMX switch. DMX control all of those 4 cameras and to switch between them. Isolating imported objects. Professional feature to prevent software crash or instability when loading custom files. L8 is the only software that can load, decode, optimize files in separate process, take only the data it needs, and then push it to the main core. We get to the last one, FP24. Import GLTF or GLB files, complex 3D files and project in those formats, and skin animation for those files also, adding different skins and animation to the audience objects. FP24 is keep developing through the year, and you should wait for another exciting feature on it. Okay, I think we've covered most of the information today and you have a great starting point to start your work with L8. Any more questions, write me in the comments and we will meet in the next time.